Hey guys, how are you all? My name is Harshit Devi, friends, and I welcome you back to my video. So in this video, friends, I will be talking with you, you know, this Kheda Satyagraha. The first information that I want to give to you, friends, is that this video has already been uploaded in Hindi. So if you are not comfortable in English, friends, you can go and watch the Hindi version of the video in the description box below. The link of the Hindi version of the video is also given. So we'll talk about the Kheda Satyagraha of 1918, friends. This is presented by me, Harshit Devi. So let's start. See, this Kheda Satyagraha, friends, was the third major movement of Gandhiji inside India. The first two major movements were the Champaran Satyagraha and the Ahmedabad Mill Strike. This Champaran Satyagraha was against the Tinkhatiya system, and this Ahmedabad Mill Strike was against the withdrawal of the plague bonus that was given to the mill workers. Okay. And the third one was the Kheda Satyagraha. So the third major movement. Who was the head of this major movement? See, Gandhiji was the spiritual head of Kheda Satyagraha. But he was not involved at ground level functioning. Who was involved at the ground level functioning? The Gandhiji's chief lieutenant at that point, Sardar Vallabh Bhai Patel, was involved at the ground level work. And he was assisted by Indulal Yagnik, Shankarlal Bankir, Mahadev Desai, Narhari Parikh, Mohanlal Pandya and Ravi Shankar Vyas. So these were the people who were assisting, you know, Vallabh Bhai Patel, and Vallabh Bhai Patel was, you know, working under the overall spiritual leadership of Gandhiji. Okay, so this was the leadership of Kheda Satyagraha, friends. So this is that picture that was taken at that point when this Kheda Satyagraha was going on. So Sardarji with his colleagues are being shown here. Shri Harprasad Desai, Shri Jeevanlal Diwan, Indulal Yagnik, Ganesh Mavlankar, Shri Mohanlal Pandya and others doing Kheda. So this is a very good pic, friends. A very, you know, this is one of the historical treasures of India, this picture. So moving forward. See, this Kheda Satyagraha, this occurred in where? It occurred in Gujarat. And actually, there was a place named Kheda in Gujarat. And obviously, at that place, the major dominant community was the Patidar peasant community. Most of the people of this Patidar community were peasants. And this movement was almost restricted to them only. Because Gandhiji and Patelji deliberately tried to make it a Gujarati struggle. They didn't want it to give it a nationalist coloring. Okay, so what happened? Why this Kheda Satyagraha took place? Let's talk about it, friends. So what happened that the Bombay presidency in 1917-18 increased the taxes by 23%. Okay, and at the same time, this Gujarat region, it, you know, suffered a severe epidemic of plague. And because of this plague, around 17,000 people lost their life. See, at that point of time, friends, there was no hygiene, no sanitation. The amount of, you know, expenditure of the government towards the health expenditure of the government was almost negligible. Okay, and the people were not having, you know, they were not having enough food grains to eat. Leave alone, you know, say, because if you have some food grains to eat, you can fill up your stomach. Okay. But even if when you are not having the sufficient amount of food grains to eat, how are you going to purchase the medicines? When the plague, you know, broke out, and when the cholera broke out, lots of people fell ill and they died. Okay. And this was basically, you know, compounded by the thing that people didn't have to eat. So this breakout of cholera and plague was the most immediate reason of the breaking out of the revolt. But the most important reason of the revolt, that this revolt was against the increased taxes. This revolt was basically against the taxes. However, the immediate reason of the breakout of the revolt was what? It was this plague and cholera and this huge amount of deaths because of it. Okay. Then also a Shapani Akal of 1899 and 1900, this I have already told you, and such other famines were also going on. Also, the taxes were increased. So the farmers were reeling heavily under the grip of poverty. They were very poor, friends. They didn't have food to eat. What will we do? And obviously, this 23% hike and this plague and cholera were compounding their difficulties. Okay. So what happened? That Sardar Vallabh Bhai Patel and his colleagues such as Narhari Parikh, Mohanlal Pandya, Ravi Shankar Vyas, they organized this major tax revolt and they mobilized all the caste and creeds of that particular region of Kheda. Okay, and this revolt was officially organized by this Gujarat Sabha. And all the peasants of Kheda signed a petition under the leadership of Sardar Patel that this tax has to be abolished, friends. And the peasants signed a petition demanded that the tax for this year should be abolished, should be scrapped. For this year, it should be scrapped. But obviously, the governor of Bombay presidency, he rejected this charter and said, he warned the peasants and farmers that if they are not going to pay the tax, their lands, their properties, their cattle will be confiscated and they will be arrested. And the governor and the Bombay presidency said that if once the land is confiscated, that land will not be returned to the people. Even if after confiscating they are agreeing to the loss, then also the land will not be returned. Okay, but despite of this warming, none of the villages were afraid of the British administration. They were steadfast in the back of Sardar Vallabhai Patel. They were supporting Sardar Vallabhai Patel. They were in favor of the movement. They were not afraid of these things. Okay, now moving forward. When this tax was not paid by the people, obviously the government will come into flow. The collectors, inspectors, they send in, you know, goons and thugs to seize the property and cattle. The police took away the lands. They took away the agrarian property of the people. But the thing was that the farmers were not resisting the arrest. They were courting arrest. The farmers were, you know, submitting themselves for arrest. And also, you know, the force was employed by the government to take away this property. But the farmers and the peasants didn't resort it with violence, because it was, the whole movement was under the leadership, the spiritual leadership of Gandhiji, and the basic principle was non-violence. Instead, the people donated their valuables and cash to the Gujarat Sabha in order to support the movement. The discipline and unity of the movement was very astounding. See, friends, you know, the people's land, livelihood, cattle, their valuables, they were being taken away by the government. Still, the people were very much firmly standing behind Sardar Vallabhai Patel. They were not being afraid of the British administration. This was the biggest thing of this movement, friends. Suppose, see, just think that your things are being taken by some people. The government is coming to your home and they are taking their, your money. They are taking your land. How will you feel? That was happening at that point of time. Still, the people were in favor of Sardar Vallabhai Patel. Such was the dignity, force of the movement at that point of time. Okay. Now, see, next. When all this was happening, there were many Gujarati people who were sympathetic to the revolts in other parts of the country. In other parts, you know, Gujarat, other parts, some people were very much sympathetic towards the people, and they were saying that this thing, whatever is happening, this is not correct. So what they did, that they started protecting the property of the peasants who were protesting against the government. They started giving, you know, shelter to the relatives of those people, because the government were at the back of them to arrest them. So they were started giving the, you know, shelter to the relatives so that government couldn't find them. So this type of help was started given by the Gujaratis to the people who were not directly involved in the movement. Also, you know, friends, obviously, if the government is confiscating the land, what will the government do with the land? It will start selling that land to some other people. Okay, for getting the land revenue, obviously. So what happened, that those Indians who came forward to buy these confiscated lands, these Indians were banished. They were excluded from the society. Okay, friends. And obviously, they were pressurized into not buying this land from the government. Okay. Also, you know, many people, many nationalists from other parts of the country said that these type of revolt should go on in the other parts of the country. But Gandhiji and Patelji, they were very much clear on the concept that this has to be a pure Gujarati struggle. A nationalist coloring was not deliberately given to this Kheda Satyagraha. The plan was to make this a pure Gujarati struggle. Now, what was the outcome of Kheda Satyagraha? Obviously, when this was happening, the government thought that now an agreement should be bought in. So the government agreed to the demands of the peasants, and the tax for that year was scrapped, and for the next year was also suspended. The increase in the rate was again reduced, and it was said that confiscated property will be returned to the people from which it was confiscated. How the government said that property which the government has already sold, that will not be ready, will be returned. It was being told the rich patidars, they will pay the taxes, but the poor peasants will not pay the taxes, friends. And obviously, the confiscated lands will be returned to their rightful owners. But the government said that when the land that we have sold to some other buyers, land will not be taken away from them. But those buyers who have bought those lands, they were also forced to return the land to the, you know, rightful owners of the land from which it was confiscated initially. So this happened as the outcome. This was basically a win for the people who were protesting against this Kheda Satyagraha. And there is one more very important information associated with this Kheda Satyagraha, is that, friends, that this Kheda Satyagraha also changed the personality of Mahatma Gandhi, because 2 years after this Kheda Satyagraha, in approximately 1921 in Madurai, Mahatma Gandhi gave up his normal attire and he started wearing a loincloth and a shawl. So Gandhiji till then, you know, he used to wear a kathiyawadi turban. But now he gave away this turban and he, you know, made himself bareheaded without even hair. Okay. And this was a milestone, you know, because now his journey from being Mohandas Karamchand Gandhi to a Mahatma, to a monk, started. Because this changed the personality of Mahatma Gandhi completely. So this was basically, friends, Kheda Satyagraha. It was basically a Gujarati, you know, struggle. It was deliberately given a Gujarati struggle by Sardar Vallabh Bhai Patel and Gandhiji. So this was basically Kheda Satyagraha, and it was a win for the concept of Satyagraha against the British authority, because at the end, British authority succumbed to the demands of the people. So I hope this video was helpful for you, friends. If this video was really helpful for you, kindly subscribe to my channel, friends. Please like this video. If you want some, you know, if you haven't liked this, you can also press the dislike button. And if you feel that you need some, you know, some improvement in this video, then that you can also suggest to me. So thank you for watching my video, friends. Thank you for being patient. I hope these things are helping you a lot, friends. Also, the Hindi version of the video is also uploaded. The link of the Hindi version of the video is given in the description box below. So you can go and watch the Hindi version if you are not comfortable in English. So thank you for watching my video, friends. Have a good day. Goodbye.